In the name of our triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. I know it happens in life, and it happens in classrooms. It happens amongst adults and sometimes amongst teachers. Have you ever been falsely accused? You know, someone points their finger at you, is like, he did it, and you didn't? I mean, more often in my life, I think I've done things that nobody noticed. I've had sinful thoughts, and nobody accused me of anything, but it happens where sometimes people say, you did it, and you didn't do it. How do you feel? Especially if maybe the teacher believes that person, and you get in trouble for it. You punished for it. Man, that's frustrating when lack of justice is done. That sort of feeling that we get is just a little bit, because we're still guilty in other ways. But Jesus was absolutely innocent as he stood before Pilate, and people just kept on falsely accusing him of stuff out of hate. They just were saying, you did it, you deserve death, you did such bad things. And Jesus was convicted of it. Jesus didn't have to take it. He could have bust out, he could have broken that justice down. But instead, he willingly took those false accusations so that when they look at you and me at the end of our lives and they say, well, you did that sin and you did that sin and I actually did it, they'll actually say, hey, you don't have to pay for those sins because Jesus already did pay for them. That's how much our Savior loves us. He chose to let himself be falsely accused of all the things that we've done, so we'll be innocent in God's sight forever. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for being willing to suffer false accusations. So in heaven, you'll look at us and declare that we are your children, perfect and innocent forever. We ask you to bless us today in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace. Amen.